Hello, everyone. Alicia and James of Matex Gears here today. James, how are you?
Terrific. Thank you. Very busy, but good.
Good. Yeah, that's the best way to be. So I'm glad to have you here today because we're going back to the basics. And if you're wondering what I mean by that, you know, we get on here and we produce all this content. We talk about, you know, different types of planetary gears that you offer, the applications, but it's been a really long time since we just answered the question, how does a planetary gear work? And there might be people here that are new to planetary gears and they're not really sure and they'd like to know that information. So James, I'm gonna go ahead and turn that one right over to you. Tell us how planetary gears work.
All right, thank you, Alicia. Basically, the function of a planetary gear is either to slow down or speed up reduction. Okay, so most of the times it's used in reducing the speed of a motor. Say most motors run at 1750 RPMs. There's all kinds of exceptions to that, but you need to slow that down. Say if it was in a car seat, you don't want 1750 RPMs. You hit your button and you're going through the windshield, you know,
right.
Into your, you know, driver's wheel. Anyway, yeah. It has to be slowed down, and it also increases torque. So as you slow it down, torque increases, just a function of gearing. So in our gears, and the picture behind you, always the motor goes into what we call the sun gear, which is the central gear. Around that float a number of what we call the planets themselves. And that is housed in a ring gear. And that's the outer one, part of it. Now the planets themselves are attached to a carrier plate. When we go in on, and they go in and out on the same axis. That's what we want to get to.
Okay.
So that's important that that motion is transferred through there. And then going through the gears itself, that causes the reduction based on the number of teeth that are involved in each part of it. So we offer gears in either a 3, 4, 5 to 1. We have some 7 to 1s, and in one line, there are 54, we offer some 6 to 1s also. So basically, I mean, that's real, real basic about how planetary gear works. It's held either on the ring gear. We have some holes to the ring gear, or you can put a bar in your housing that would hold that also. And we don't sell housing, so that's important to for people to know. But housing is generally, people want the option to create their own housing for their own particular application. And so we sell the gears themselves and all the accessories that go with them. So,
all right.
I mean, that's a real basic rundown of what a planetary gear is.
That's what we were looking for today. We just, like I said, we wanted to get back to the basics, and that was a perfect overview. And we did get to see the image, like you said, on screen. That kind of showed us where each of those components that you mentioned tie into the gear. So thank you so much, James, for joining me today and telling us a little bit more about how planetary gears work. And if you're watching this video right now and you're interested in learning more, you want to learn about the applications that planetary gears are involved in, or just about the different options available at Matex, make sure you're checking them out online at matexgears.com. Thanks for watching.